Hello everyone, in today's video we will cover the topic of cirrhosis of liver. Now let us look at the definition. It is defined as a diffuse process characterized by, the important thing is, fibrosis and conversion of normal architecture of liver to structurally abnormal regenerative nodules of hepatocytes. Basically, in the process of cirrhosis, we will see two changes. The first change is fibrosis, that is the formation of fibrous tissue, which will help in formation of septa. And the other thing is, we will see nodules that are regenerative. The newly formed nodules will be present. These will be synthesized by the cell's hepatocytes. Now, classification is based on morphology. Morphology means on the basis of appearance. Either the nodules which are formed may be small or large or may be of mixed variety. When the size is less than 3 mm, it is known as micronodular. When the size is more than 3 mm, it is known as macronodular, and in the mixed variety we will see both kind of nodules, that are micro as well as macro. Now the other classification is based on the etiology, the cause behind the cirrhosis. It can be because of alcohol consumption, known as alcohol cirrhosis. This is most common type. Almost 60 to 70% cases are of alcohol cirrhosis. It may be because of some virus infection. In the last video, we have seen HBV and HCV virus infecting the liver, which can cause necrotic changes and further can result into fibrosis. It may be biliary cirrhosis, pigment cirrhosis, cardiac cirrhosis, cirrhosis in Wilson's disease, and cirrhosis in alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency. It is a kind of plasma protein. So this was the definition and this was the classification. Now we will see the pathogenesis. The main topic covered will be, how is the fibrous tissue formed? So these are the normal cells, liver cells. The liver cells are also known as hepatocytes. So these are hepatocytes. And in the liver, we see sinusoid space, which will drain it. So this further goes into the, it drains into the central vein. Between the hepatocytes and the sinusoids, there is some space in which cells are present. These cells which are present here are called stellate cells. Stellate means star-like on the shape. They have a zigzag sort of shape, so it is known as stellate cells. Or the other name is intocells, or the other name is perisinusoidal cells. So what basically happens when the hepatocytes are damaged? They are damaged. They may be damaged because of alcohol, maybe virus infection, other sort of inflammation. When they are damaged, they activate the stellate cells. Hepatocytes damage, it will further activate stellate cells. This activation is with the help of TGF, that is tissue growth factor, cytokines. This will start secreting substance, its depository substance outside, which will result in formation of a matrix around it. A fibrous matrix formation will start taking place here. So the formed matrix will be called ECM, that is extracellular matrix. Now, as the damage is increasing, activation will increase, the matrix will grow further, and gradually this matrix will form fibrous tissue there. So that is the pathogenesis of formation of fibrous tissue. Now, when this fibrous tissue will increase in amount, it will start compressing the sinusoidal space. It will put pressure on the sinusoid. So the sinusoidal space will be more of a compressed space. So what we will see is it will compress the sinusoid. As there is compression in the sinusoid, further the central vein will be compressed. Central vein is compressed. Therefore, the portal tension will increase. That is known as portal hypertension. This will further pressurize the underlying layer and the fluid will escape out. It will go into the peritoneal cavity, where this fluid will cause a condition known as ascites. This will cause a condition called as ascites. The size of spleen might increase, so it can cause splenomegaly. As the liver is damaging, therefore the liver function will be decreased. So all this is in the pathogenesis. Now we will see the clinical features of the disease. In clinical features, initially we will see the person will feel weakness, weight loss, anorexia, and gradually, as this is a irreversible process, the fibrosis which is taking place in the liver is irreversible. So in advanced changes, we will see damage to the liver. The hepatic function will be disturbed. Now the most important hepatic function is detoxification. Therefore, it will be decreased. As the hepatic function is decreased, detoxification will decrease, which will lead to accumulation of the products toxin products in the body. The most common example is ammonia. It accumulates in the body, gradually its amount increases, it can cross the blood-brain barrier, enter the brain, and it can cause encephalopathy. The other function of liver is estrogen metabolism. This will also be decreased. It will result in increased amount of estrogen in the blood. Other changes which we can see will include, we have discussed them, portal hypertension, ascites, splenomegaly, and portal systemic shunt. We can also see, because of decrease in function of liver, the bilirubin conjugation will be disturbed. Decreases, it can also lead to jaundice. Certain clotting factors will be decreased. They may cause small hemorrhages in the blood. Plasma proteins which are synthesized in the liver are also decreased, like albumin. The diagnosis of this condition can be done with the help of liver biopsy to study for the fibrotic bands present and the nodules, the regenerative nodules. In lab test, we can look for increased amount of bilirubin in blood, because conjugation is not possible, so bilirubin will increase. All the liver enzymes, as the hepatocyte damage, the liver enzyme will come into the blood and their concentration will be increased than normal, like AST, ALT, transaminase, alkaline phosphatase. And now if we look at the treatment, first of all, this is an irreversible condition. So the damaged one, once done, cannot be resumed back to normal. So first we can try to stop the cause. Like if the person is consuming alcohol, we can stop its use. If the person is having any type of hepatitis infection, we can try to treat that. And the other possible treatment is transplant of liver. That's all for the topic of cirrhosis of liver. That's all for the video. Thanks for watching.